Hello, welcome to the next chapter of SRv6 demonstrations. Last time we have shown SRv6 in ISIS, and today we will explain how layer 3 VPN works in the SRv6 environment. Today we will show few different SRv6 layer 3 VPN implementations using SRv6 microsite technology. Our topology is quite simple. We have an IPv6 network with some IGP protocol, and we have several PE routers connected to it. Three platforms are from Cisco portfolio. It is custom silicon-based ASR 9000, then Jericho-based NCS 5500, and virtual router XRV9K. Then we have Arcus router running ArcOS, which is based on Jericho 2. And last but not least, we are having a Linux server which will run open source implementation of BGP protocol written in Go called GoBGP. Here is a small exception, and Linux doesn't run any IGP protocol, and reachability is based on a static routing. To every PE router in the topology, we have connected CE router. Except for Linux. On the Linux server, we are running just a simple container, and also for fast data plane, we are running FDIO VPP. First things first, let's try to explain how layer 3 VPN with SRv6 microsite works. For this explanation, we will simplify our topology and we will show it on two routers only. We already know that each PE in the SRv6 network has its own locator, and that locator is advertised into IGP protocol. So every device in the network knows how to reach those prefixes. Our locators are from unique local address space, but they can be very well from global address space. We also know that there must be some PECE routing. The most common PECE routing protocol is BGP. Here, we have an IPv4 unicast address family. For VPN, we also need an IBGP session over the core. It is obviously VPN v4 unicast address family, typically through router vector. Of course, CE will advertise some prefixes, so CE1 will advertise 10.10.10.1, for example, and CE3 will advertise 10.10.10.3. So far, everything is identical to MPLS. Now, once PE receives the prefix, it doesn't need to allocate any label. It allocates SRv6 function instead. Here, NCS5500 receives prefix over eBGP session, so it creates an update in VPN v4 address family with route distinguisher, with appropriate route target, and on top of that it will add function. In our case, function is UDT4. Different UDT4 is assigned to each configured VRF on PE router. So PE router will advertise all prefixes from that particular VRF to the route reflector together with SRv6 function. Then ingress PE stores prefix and function into his FIB and advertises prefix towards the ingress CE. Once the control plane is set up, ingress CE can start sending packet towards a particular destination. When the packet reaches to ingress PE, it is encapsulated into IPv6 based on programmed FIB entry, where the destination IP address is the UDT4 function of egress PE. Throughout the whole network, packet is routed based on IGP protocol entry, and once it reaches egress PE, it will get decapsulated and the inner packet is sent towards the egress CE. So, on egress PE, we can see how the route is received from CE and how BGP advertises prefix towards route reflector together with SRv6 VPN SID. On ingress PE, we can see the received prefix in VPN v4 address family together with UDT function. And also we can see how it is programmed into the RIP. Obviously, this concept allows us to have full CE to CE connectivity. So let's try ping from CE3 towards the CE1. And the same principle is applied across the whole network. Each CE advertises a set of prefixes, each PE has its own locator and allocates different SRv6 function for different VRFs and advertise them to all neighbors through the route reflector. GoBGP is connected to the same route reflector. Hence, we can take a look using GoBGP client to see all prefixes advertised by all our PE routers. And GoBGP is capable, besides showing all BGP attributes, to show us also all SRv6 SID related information. So here we can see all details from the BGP advertisement of our 10.10.10.1 prefix in our VPN. But GoBGP itself is just a control plane. We can use it only to monitor prefixes, to advertise prefixes, and so on. But fortunately, it has API, so we can do all those things programmatically. And also, FDIO has its own API. And because SRv6 was created with programmability in mind, it is super simple to create a small application, which based on a configuration creates UDT function in VPP and also creates BGP advertisement in GoBGP of the container IP address. The same application will receive all VPN prefixes from the network via GoBGP API and create SRv6 policies and steer traffic to them on VPP. So let's try to run our little application and we can see how it programs UDT4 functions into the VPP and forces GoBGP to advertise prefix 10.10.10.5 with it. And also reads all BGP VPN prefixes from GoBGP and programs them as a policies into VPP. And now we have our network complete and we can reach our containerized application from any of the CEs and vice versa. Here we have the container and we can try to ping, for example, CE1. And using Wireshark, we can see encapsulated packet from container to CE1. The inner packet is IPv4 with ICMP. And in outer IPv6 header, we can see the destination is UDT4 function. Well, we have demonstrated full L3 VPN interoperability among 5 different SRv6 implementations. We have shown full control and dataplane functionality. We have also demonstrated the simple programmability of SRv6 across different platforms. All devices in the demonstration, we're using SRv6 microSID, which allows excellent MTU efficiency and is very hardware friendly. And of course, all this works exactly the same way with VPN v6 address family and UDT6 function. That's it. If you want more, a best source of information is always segment-routing.net. Thank you very much. Goodbye.